A lot of times I sit here and I press the record button and it's just like nothing is moving. You know what I'm saying? Like it's crazy sometimes, but you know, I really do need to get my PC built and done. But hey, it's money out of my pocket, right? So taking my time to get it done. Anyways, for this one, we're only doing one episode today. Because there's 13 episodes in the season. So I'm going to save the double upload for next time. I might put it out on the weekend, but I'm not sure yet. Today is Thursday for y'all. It's only one episode today, but I'm going to just try to finish up the season with a double upload. It might come out this weekend or next week, whenever I get time to do it. If I get time to do it on Saturday, then I will do it on Saturday, because I usually do an 8-hour recording session, is what I started to do with The Walking Dead and The Last Kingdom. So if I had, I think I can do two episodes of this for an extra couple of hours. We'll see how things go. It's just a one-time thing just to finish up the season, and then we'll jump into the next season the week after. But we'll see how things go. But only one episode today, episode 11, mainly because I really just want to see what happens. What are they going to do now after Gemma has told them what happened to her? So that's really what I really wanted to see, why I'm jumping into another episode tonight. I was going to record both of them, but then I said there's only two more episodes left after this. Let me just do this one and then do a double upload next to end the season, because we could do the season finale by itself. But I was like, nah, I want to see two at a time. But for this one, but I already recorded two episodes today, so three is not bad. Okay, so let's jump into it, and I will see you guys for the review. Alright, so this is the review for Season 2, Episode 11 of Sons of Anarchy. Sorry guys, you only get one episode today. So, what I'm going to try to do is, you're watching this on Thursday, so I'm going to try to put this out. I'm going to try to get you guys those episodes on Saturday, season finale, and then we pick up after a week or whatever the situation is for Season 3. We'll see how things go. But this episode was very well done, very well written, in my opinion. And right now, it seems like, in my opinion, they have really shined a light on Opie's acting in Season 2. The guy that is playing Opie, man, he, in my opinion, he's been doing the best job throughout this season. So throughout this second season, he has been killing this season. I don't think anybody else has really been acting like he deserves, my opinion. Let me know if this actor received the Emmy, because he must have definitely got nominated. If he did not get nominated the year of when season 2 came out or whatever, if he didn't get nominated for an Emmy for that year, for at least best supporting actor or something of the sort, that would really surprise me. Because 11 episodes in, and I have to say that is some of the best acting that I've seen in a very long time. And that is high praises coming from me, because I've seen plenty of acting, and I'm telling you right now, Opie is the best actor every time he's on screen for this season. Last season, not so much, because he wasn't the focus. Jax was the main focus of season 1. But season 2, the focus has really been Opie and how he's reacting to stuff. Every interaction he had, he killed every scene he was in so far. And even that interaction that he had with Stahl, killed it. The moment killed it. But it would really surprise me if he's never been nominated for an Emmy for this show, because he's killing this season. I'm not going to lie. As I said before, he might have become my favorite actor in the show right now. I'm not even kidding. Not necessarily favorite character, but favorite actor. Okay, so I definitely see and appreciate the acting in the show. They have been killing this season, and you guys have told me that it gets even better, so I'm looking forward to it. Jax also, this episode, I wanted to see what his reaction was going to be, and they handled it pretty good. The writing, the way how they handled it, even though Piney came in at the end, he was bussing. You know what I'm saying? He was ready, and I know he was gonna go in there bussing. You know, I was just hoping that nobody died, and nobody did, and I'm happy about that, because I wouldn't have wanted to see that happen, or happen to Opie, or happen to Clay, or whatever. As much as I don't like Clay, I would rather him step down. I don't want to see him get killed, but he needs to step down. I thought Opie was going to bring it up in the meeting when he asked him anything else. I thought Opie was going to be like, I think you should step down and let Jax be president. And that would have probably raised some eyebrows, but probably that is not part of the rules. I don't know how stuff like that go. I don't know how leadership change when it comes. Oh, you're back? Oh, okay. You know, I've been sitting here waiting on my computer to load so I can finish this review. I mean, it just pauses for no reason. But anyways, let's continue. I'll just cut that part out. So when it comes on to this show, and as I said before, acting is great. The writing is great. So far, so good. I still think episode 10 of this season is the best episode. But definitely 11 really put out a lot. There was a lot put into that episode. It's a lot of stuff happening in episode 11. A lot of things, you know, between Opie finding out what really happened to Donna, causing the club, him following Stahl and finding out that Chibs is actually a, you know, almost signed a thing working with the feds, and also Stahl them seeing the gun handoff with the IRA daddy of the dude they captured, and who else? What else? There's a lot of stuff that was stuffed into that episode. Jax following, you know, Zobel, and finding out that they're working with the Mayans. I mean, there was a lot of stuff that was stocked into that episode, and I still think it's a great episode. The pacing was great. We found out a lot. I think they wanted to do that because they're about to ramp things up for the final two episodes, so they kind of get all this information in so that we can kind of stretch out the ending of the second season. So we'll see how that turns out. But anyways, I'm happy you guys have tuned in to watch my reaction, man. I really do appreciate all 150 of y'all that, you know, come through and watch these reactions, man. I know it's probably people, I don't think anybody out that's not subscribed to the channel watch Sons of Anarchy on my channel. I don't think so. Maybe, but I think it's mostly people that's on the channel that's already subscribed to the channel that watches these reactions. I'm trying to watch shows on the channel, man, that, you know, that has very compelling story. And if it's not a compelling story, I'm probably going to drop the series if I start watching it and the story doesn't get good enough to interest me. I'm probably going to drop it. That hasn't happened yet on the channel, but I promise you, if you suggest some doo-doo show and I'm watching it, it will be dropped off of this channel. I love compelling stories. If it's not about that, you know what I'm saying? If it's just something that's funny, then that's different. If it's funny stuff with no story behind it, I'll do something like that, but I have to go in knowing. But if you tell me it's a good story and then when I get in, it's not, I am going to shit on the show. I'm not even kidding with you. I'm going to shit on it, literally, and call it doo-doo. But anyways, thank you guys so much. Make sure you leave a like, leave a comment, and I will catch up with you guys later, man. Peace.